Good evening, sir, and batchmates. Today, we team number 8 are going to present our business plan. Our business plan, it's a company called Jars, which basically deals with whey protein ice cream. Next slide, please.
Wow. Whey protein ice cream. Wow.
So, our company, Jars, first of all, to give a small glimpse of how we arrived with the name. So, basically, Jars, it's a combination of all the four team members of this name. You know, the first letter is taken and the company name is arrived. So, based on our research, we have decided that our company will be situated in Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. So, getting to the roles, me, Shivranjani, will be the director who makes a strategic and operational decision of the companies. And then Ankush, who will be the marketing lead, and he will be working with the marketing team to create, deliver, edit, and optimize all the marketing materials. Mr. Jagdish will be the developer who identifies the opportunities, and also he evaluates the business performance. He also helps us to maximize our business reach and potential. Ravi Kumar will be the sales manager who designs the strategic plan and expands company's customer base, and that he ensures that our company gets a strong presence everywhere. Next slide, please. Jars Whey Protein Ice Cream. So here I'm going to explain the vision and mission statement of our company. So our vision is to provide a place.
Sorry to interrupt. So you are, would you be presenting something on the market research as a part of the whole project?
Yes, sir, just a glimpse of what is the conclusion of the research.
Okay. That you are not making a separate presentation on that.
That's included in this.
Including. Okay.
Consolidated the inference.
Sorry to disturb you. Please go ahead. Sorry. Excellent.
Vision statement. Like our vision is to provide a place that gives you a full-time experience of rich taste along with the health, and also to be a market leader. Our mission is that we provide the ice cream that is filled not only with taste but also the nutrients that that goes for every customers of all ages, with variety of seasonal and non-seasonal and other flavors. Our core value is honesty, trust, customer commitment, and innovation. Next slide, please.
Wow.
To begin with, we made a market research. So we basically went for the questionnaire method that was made online. So the responses we got is like 130 responses, which was varied from 6 states in the online survey. So based on the responses, we got about maximum 54% of respondents were from Andhra Pradesh, followed by Tamil Nadu, on the basis of which we decided our target place which the company should be situated. And the frequency of the product, that is the ice cream, that we found is that more than 53% prefer to have ice cream at least once a month, followed by 20% preferring at least once a week. And the customers are don't want to spend more than 100 per serve. So this so on this basis we also decided the amount or the price that has to be allocated. And the preference is that people are found to have many wide ranges of flavor preferences, which is a plus point for us, for because like we can go and experiment with large number of flavors. And also the best point is that more than 50% of the respondents are ready to get to have a protein rich ice cream than the normal one they used to have. Next slide, please. So goals and objectives. Our goals is to prepare the ice cream that utilizes the whey protein instead of the skim milk protein that has been already always been utilized in the traditional ice cream that we have. And we also, our main motto is to provide the income to the milk producers and creating a rural employment opportunities. Our objective is to setting up integrated unit for dairy processing with a higher value and demand, and also maximizing the utilization of milk produce by utilizing its byproducts also. And also reducing our reducing the pollution by use of effluent treatment and fully utilizing the raw materials. Next, roles and responsibility. So our company has mainly this production department, human resource department, finance department, and marketing department. Production department handles the planning, execution, and the report analysis and the production analysis. They also assure the quality and product testing and the maintenance of laboratory and safety and pollution control. And the human resource department mainly they manages the manpower planning and also the recruitment and selection. They also work for the betterment of the labor force that is working in our company, and manages the overall employee motivation. The finance department mainly prepares the accounts, plan the internal finance transactions, and also resource finance allocation and pay creditors, and the manages the employee wages and salaries. Marketing department, they develop the pricing strategies and also promotions, and so in order to boost our sales. Next slide, please. So basically, our whey protein ice cream. The concept of whey protein ice cream is how it's different from the normal ice cream is the health nutritional factor that includes, because whey protein has major optimum calcium and phosphate absorption, and also it is the liquid byproduct remaining after the milk has been curdled and strained. So the whey protein is a healthy alternative than the skim milk that we have been using, and also there is a significant fewer calories than what we have in an ice cream, and also there is an a good growth of beneficial gut bacteria present in this ice cream, so there is also enhances the muscle growth and weight loss. Next slide, please. Our processing unit consists of mainly this equipments, homogenizer, pasteurizer, and freezing. So when the raw material, that is our milk, is blended, the milk cream and the milk powder, whey protein, and the liquid stabilizers are fed into the mixing tank, and there is an analyzation of solids and fats, and this is taken into stable emulsion at the fat and water interface of the mix, and added with stability of serum, that is the non-fat phase of the mix. And it is put in the pasteurizer, where it is pasteurization process is done to improve the water mixing quality and gelling properties of the ice cream. And further, it is freezed and in a -5 to -6 degrees Celsius, where it helps to form the ice crystals and improve the quality of the product. And further, it is taken into packaging and hardening. We are going with various packages according to our research. Next slide.
Excellent. Other members,
half of our time is completed. Please look into it.
Other members also will be presenting.
Yes. Good evening, sir. Everyone. Myself, Ankush Kumar, I'm going to present marketing research. And there are 4 P's in marketing research: then product, price, place, and promotion. Like in the product,
Sir. Sivaranjani, have you completed?
Sivaranjani is completed.
My part is done. Now Ankush will take over.
Brilliant. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Like in the product, we are a startup, so we are going with the one product only in the beginning. So our product mainly defined by the market research. So as many of the respondents respond that they like a different flavor, so we are going with all the flavors like vanilla, chocolate, and all. And we are giving the product in different packages, like packaging like cones, bars, and like that. So we are our products are like choco caramel, choco almonds, and the kismis kaju. So there are many more products also. Then the price part. So our input cost depends from the input cost we derive that price should be 300 per liter. It is somewhat greater than the competitive markets, because it is somewhat added product, like whey protein is added in that. So for the research suggests that the target customers do not want to buy do not want to spend more than 100 rupees on the ice cream. So we are going with the lower weight ice cream also, like in the 200 ml pack, 300 ml pack, like for that we are going with the 10 rupees, 20 rupees, 50 rupees pack. So for the place, we are our market research suggests that most of the respondents are from Andhra Pradesh, Visakhapatnam. So we are going, we are targeting the Visakhapatnam market in the beginning, and then we are going to expand that in the nearby states also as we grow. So about the promotion, we are promoting in the local newspaper. So we are local newspaper and promoting in the school events also. And we are giving discounts on if a person buys higher quantity. So we are giving a discount like 20%, 30% on that. We will discuss that in later slides.
Thank you.
Yes. Then our mark, our value channel. Our main objective is to provide a product, best product to the customers. So we
Ankush, sorry to interrupt. We are crossing 10 minutes, so you can make it faster.
Okay. Then first is the suppliers. For the suppliers, we have to buy the raw materials like whey protein, milk. So we are contacting directly with the dairy farmers. So we are providing them the chilled trucks so that we can buy from them, and there is no like time shortage in that. So in then we have the company in the middle. In the company we have the packaging and all that. So in the packaging, different packagings are there, and we have a we have a team, inspection team also, which inspects the product, like they are good or not. Then they pass the product as well. So we have outbound logistics also. In the outbound outbound logistics, we have warehouses. So and we have chilled trucks also, so that no place is left to deliver the product. So every so the product is delivered on time at every place. So at last we have marketing and sales team, which derives the consumer towards them, and then the sales team also, which sells the product. Next slide, please. Then how can we improve our visibility? So we can conduct the fun challenges, like who can eat ice cream in lesser time, more ice cream in lesser times, and then we can host Super Sunday markets also, and then we can host we can sponsor like school events, sports events, and the gym events also, as we our product is whey protein, so gym people are more interested in that. So we can also go for e-commerce optimizations, like we can sell our products on Swiggy, Zomato from our stores also. Yes. Next slide.
Super. Okay. Next from slide. Now I will continue.
Yes. Go ahead. Fantastic.
Good evening, Great. Sir and batchmates. Now I'm going to continue in regards to the financial aspects. You know that fixed capital is nothing but it consists of the assets which are not consumed or destroyed in the production of a goods or services, generally properties, equipment and plants are comes under the fixed cost. When we calculated the fixed cost of our plant, it came around 1,94,24,200. Next, you people know that working capital is nothing but it's amount of capital that is needed for the company for day-to-day activities. When we calculated by including salary, wages, raw materials, utilities like power and everything, it accounts to be 6,10,21,400. So total investment is nothing but, you know, fixed capital plus working capital, it accounts to be 8,04,45,600. Next, a cost of production. Cost of production is nothing but the total cost incurred by any business to produce a specific quantity of a product.
Wow.
Here we are producing the whey protein. For this, our total cost of production is 7,14,23,402 within a year. Here we also included depreciation of all these things. And total turnover, and we assumed that the cost per liter is a 300. So for after selling 2,80,000 liters of ice cream in a year, our turnover accounts to be 8,40,00,000. And I will just give you a grief of all these things, like total cost of production is 7,14,23,402 and turnover is 8,40,00,000. And the net profit, you know that total cost of production, turnover minus cost of production, and net profit ratio is net profit by turnover into 100. And payback period, we calculate a payback period by using the total investment by the annual net cash revenue. It was found to be 6 years, 5 months. And the break-even point in terms of sales volume, that is total cost by sales per unit cost minus cost per unit incurred by the company, it accounts to be, for break-even point, accounts to be 19,83,983 liters. And the rate of return is 5.6%. When we calculated benefit cost ratio, it was 1.19. That is, when we invested 1 rupee, we are getting 1.19 rupee in a return.
Love.
And this is the development of our enterprise in 10 years. So I just give you a glimpse how we done this calculation within a minute. Like in the first year, we assumed the total income as a 4%. And in the for the upcoming years, we assumed that there is a growth in income as 5%, and expenditure, we assumed that there is a growth of 3%, and the profit before interest tax and everything, you know, the depreciation we assumed as this as a 5%, and interest on term loan, we assumed that we'd taken a 2 crore loan from the bank at an interest rate of 10%, and the repayable period is 10 years, and PAD and I means nothing but profit after depreciation and interest. And we assume the tax we are paying as 30%. PADIT is nothing but profit after depreciation, interest and tax.
Yes.
And the profit margin is, a profit margin is nothing but gross profits by revenue. In the first year, when we calculate profit margin based on these assumptions, it accounts to be 8.9%. And at the end of 10 years, it was accounted to be 18.14%.
Wow.
And next to SWOT analysis will be...
Good job.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Thank you for every batchmates. And finally, coming to the SWOT analysis, as it's a new product and a new company coming into the market. First, analyzing all the strengths. Our strength is a natural ingredient, which is a healthy ingredient, which is most favored by the consumers in recent times. And the second one is the forward integration with the digital optimization, or the digital optimization in the e-commerce markets. So, and then the R&D department, which we did not actually show in the slide, but we included in it in the report, the R&D department continuing on the innovation in the whey protein. So how do we replace the total skim milk with this whey protein? We are going to experiment with in that. And then use ingredients which strengthen bones and teeth. So actually this, we got it into strength because usually children doesn't prefer the children doesn't prefer the benefits of any ice cream, but we, as we concentrated on all the target customer age groups, we concentrated on the health benefits also, so we can show it as a strength. And coming to weaknesses, first of all, as it is a startup for us, we'll obviously for the first 5 years we'll be with a low promotion, and we'll be with a low technology and with a low brand image. So for any kind of startups, these are the common weaknesses that we have put into. And for the opportunities, rather than running around the promotion, we thought we should be strong with distribution channel for the first 5 years. So we thought the strong distribution channel, and especially in the place we chose, the Visakhapatnam, the largest population district within Andhra Pradesh and the largest district with GDP of $23 million. So we thought there would be a strong distribution channel for the ice cream segment. And then the technology we use, as I said earlier, the forward integration of digital technology in the e-commerce platform, that will be our opportunities, because in recent times all are shifting to the e-commerce platforms. And the effective production, as I said, we are not focusing mostly on the promotion aspect, but we are focusing on the R&D and the technology aspect. And finally coming to the most important thing, the threats. First of all, less market share, because almost all the developed brands have already occupied the market in Visakhapatnam. But there are other aspects which we taken into consideration to start our startup in Visakhapatnam, because of the scenario or because of the position it is. It has with various number of colleges, various number of schools, and we also can include beach as its tourism part. And then the second is the competitors. As I said, as already we have less market share and there are already established brands, so competitors will be a big threat for us. And then the weather condition, as it is almost located near the coastal area, we face with various weather parameter weather difficulties, because we depend on the animal producers, so the logistics operations may disturb, our milk production may disturb, so that may depend on the weather parameters. And then coming to the inflation, because as it is not an essential product, because when the inflation increases, usually our consumption of product decreases, so it is considered to be a threat for us. And then the electricity, because our total production and our total integration will depend on the electricity, so if electricity is not there, we cannot produce any even one unit of ice cream, so that can be considered as a threat. Next.
Done.
Thank you all for patient listening.
Let's give a big round of applause to team number 8. My God, did a great job. There's so much of appreciation pouring in for you in the chat box, team 8. You know, friends appreciating you generously and very well. They liked it. Your slides, your pictures, your analysis, your presentation, your teamwork. That is a great job, my God. I loved it.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Loved it. Excellent. Any questions to team number 8? You can ask questions. It's absolutely fine. If you ask questions, they cannot answer. Also, marks will not be cut from that. Okay. But questions can be asked for learning.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. But really, Sayuja, you said it, man. Sayuja really said the perfect statement, you know what he said, what exactly I also felt. And I am so happy team 8 came forward voluntarily. And Sayuja said, you guys have set benchmark. I loved that statement. Really, team 8, thank you very much.
Sir, there's a question for team 8. There's a question, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, the legal compliances of FSSI, food safety regulation, were not discussed about the product. Are there any, were they skipped or they are not taken into part of those things?
Actually, we have included the legal course in our report. Actually, for the time constraint, we did not include here. I mean, along taking with this, the new recent regulations which they have put for the school children also, we have included in our report actually.
Oh, wow. Good question. Excellent question asked and very well answered. But thing is, I want to understand in this team of 4 people, are there any people with technology background or something?
Sir, I have one question.
Okay.
I want to.
Yeah, Mukul, before you ask, I'm expecting an answer from the team 8. Are you basically from AgriBay? Is there somebody from the technology department who studied something? Or you're all basically from Agri background? All 4 of you? Ravi?
Yes, Ankush?
Simon, yes, sir. I am from B.Tech engineering.
B.Tech engineering, okay. Simon, yes, sir. From?
Horticulture graduate, sir.
Horticulture, okay, very good. And Jagdish?
I'm agriculture background, sir.
Jagdish, agriculture. Ravi Kumar also agriculture, no?
Yes, sir.
But great job. You took this topic and you dealt with this in a very nice manner. Excellent job. Mukul has a question. Then Rajesh also will ask a question. Mukul will ask a question first. Thank you. Good.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. So I want to know whey product is a byproduct of the dairy industry. And one more thing is that in the ice cream, there is 80% overrun is there. Only air is present is there. But the cost of that whey protein ice cream is 300 per liter. So I want to know it is more than that of competitive ice cream present by Amul and Mother Dairy.
But every other competitor is not providing the whey.
Okay, Ankush, you can answer, Ankush.
Yes,
sir. Let him answer.
Yeah, Mukul, every other competitor is not providing the whey in their ice cream. So whey costs high. Whey protein, like we can see in the supplement, gym supplement also, whey cost about like 3,000 per kg. So it cost high because of this whey protein. Like ice cream cost is not that high if we see from the, if we do not add that whey protein, so ice cream cost will be low. But if we are adding from the health factor, like whey protein, so it's cost high.
Mukul, can I ask you a written question for you, please?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, how much do you have ice cream per serve? I mean, for month or once a week, how much do you have?
Sir, once in a week or?
Yeah, how much quantity?
4 a family, we will take 750 ml pack once in a week or sometime twice in a week.
Wow. You can consider that price with our competitors' price. What we buy in the market presently is costing around 225 rupees per 750 ml. So you can compare our 1 liter of 300 with our competitors' price. So we adjusted the price according to the serve, because I mean 300 per liter usually seems to be big, but we usually have 50 ml per serve, or if we take the family packs, we usually take 250 ml. So accordingly, we have put that.
And
One more thing for people who don't afford that price, can you make some product, innovative product in a small packaging, small serving?
Yes, we have mentioned that in our PPT. Like we are
our core values, one of our core values is innovation. So actually, it's a startup, we cannot start like that. So once we develop after 10 years, if it's going good, we can innovate the product. As we said, one of our strength is also R&D technology rather than promotion.
Yeah,
Thank you so much, sir, for your answer. I'm really happy for the, that.
Thank you, Mukul. Thank you, Mukul, for asking such nice questions. And definitely,
sir, I have one question.
Rahul has a question. Yeah.
Sir, it's a new startup, right? You are investing more than crores for this startup. It's worth to invest initially that amount of money.
Yes, sir. I mean, according to the new regulations, the Ministry of Finance has changed the definitions of micro, small, and medium enterprises. So with this, we come under the segment of the small enterprise, which investment is less than 10 crores. And then we can also segment according to the turnover, but as it is a startup, we cannot segment actually, but it comes under small. So almost they have reduced the tax for this MSMEs. So I think in the current scenario, with this investment under the segment of small enterprise, we can get along with us.
Yeah, you will get some government
incentives. Thank you, sir.
And what is your setback policy for this?
Sir, I did not get your question.
In case the plan fails, what is the recovery policy?
Yes, sir. Sure. Because as ice cream is already established product, the one and only addition thing that we are doing is, the new addition to the already existing thing is the blending of whey protein. So if we could exclude that whey protein, we can usually sell this ice cream because that's not a problem.
No, in case your brand doesn't work and you need to close down your business, then what will be the recovery policy for how will you convince your funding firms that you will return their money?
Yes, sir. Sure. That's a good question. Sir, first of all, we actually thought that if we go according to the normal operations, we break even at 6 years, 5 months. If it doesn't happen, the equipment and the machinery and all that value sets some value of around 1 crore, 1 lakh, around that figure, which I cannot exactly crore. Remember now.
Yes.
And we can assure by merging with already existing ones. I mean, we anyway already have a machinery. So if there is an existing brand in Vishakhapatnam, we can merge with them. I mean, we can collude our business with them so that we can get only minimal profit, but we can sustain ourselves. I mean, we cannot totally lose ourselves.
Interesting. Very good. Thank you very much. Excellent. That's a beautiful question which Ashutosh asked, you know, especially the funders, the people who are going to invest, who are going to give you fund, you know, to very well fixed capital, working capital. If you're looking for some loans and finance, they would ask you, they would also look at some kind of exit cost. Suppose you have to, you have to exit. If they have to exit, or if the company has to exit from this business, the cost for exit cost, you would lose out something. And that's a good question because from the investor point of view, that's a very good question. But don't you think the six years of, period is a bit long for becoming break-even? Can't you make it earlier to make it more attractive for the investors to invest in you? Or is for the ice cream industry, is it normal?
Yes, I mean, that depends on our innovative products that will be introduced within 2 or 3 years of our existence.
Okay. As of now,
we can introduce only one product.
Okay. Good. Great job. Excellent. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I could understand your entire team is having a very good comprehension of what you are talking. You have put in your effort, understood the project. And I'm so happy you brought out so many cost parameters, investment parameters, finance parameters. And you made such a beautiful presentation. Like Sai just said, you have set a benchmark. Now for the rest of the teams, it's going to be, challenge. Thank you very much. Good job, Dan.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.